SpaceX's massive Starship could have its second test flight later on this week. With testing in Texas, its operational future will be on the Cape.
West 2 Space Coast Bureau Chief Scott Heidler spoke to experts on what to expect and what needs to happen before liftoff.
It leads the pack. SpaceX's Starship is the most powerful and biggest rocket ever built. But it has yet to reach deep space, let alone orbit. It has taken to flight, though, a test flight back in April. Facing FAA and other regulatory approvals, a second test flight could come this week.
I know that SpaceX is still working internally toward the 17th this Friday, but again, they don't have the final paperwork, and so they can't sort of formally schedule anything.
The first test ended in a huge explosion a few minutes into flight. A self-destruct was triggered on the nearly 400-foot rocket, as there was an issue at stage separation and power loss of some of the 33 first-stage Raptor engines.
I think if they get through the first stage firing and everything goes well, that's kind of a success. And then we'll see what happens at stage separation, and then if Starship goes off and flies, there will be lots of things to look at.
And one of those things will be the pad upgrades to handle all that thrust. The first test decimated the launch pad, a massive dust and concrete storm at liftoff.
Well, the testing for Starship has been and will continue to be down in Boca Chica, Texas. Its operational hub will be right here on the Space Coast, and there are big plans for it.
I'm sure we'll see many Starship launches from here as they move forward. I think the reason, one of the main reasons why they're doing the testing down there in Texas is that they sort of have first dibs on everything there. They're not competing with anybody else in a busy launch schedule.
In fact, if all goes as planned, Starship will make it in the history books as it's scheduled to take NASA astronauts to the lunar surface in Artemis 3 mission as early as 2025. First human footprints on the moon since Apollo 17, 51 years ago. On the Space Coast, Scott Heidler, West 2 News.